Going to be showing you how to rebuild your saved segments on your ZVM system. A saved segment is an area of virtual memory, which we call virtual storage, that's assigned a name and loaded with data or programs, then saved in a system data file in spool space. If one or more segments have been purged and you want them back, this is what you'll do. This procedure is laid out in Chapter 3 of Saved Segments Planning and Administration, linked below. A disclaimer. The system I'm using is purely for demonstration purposes and may or may not follow best practices. Production systems will vary. So a typical ZVM system, freshly installed, has a number of NSSs, or name saved segments, or simply segments, by default, such as CMS and CMS-BAM, which will be used in this demo. So first we need to sign on to our service user ID, which by default is main, followed by the release number, which for me is 720 because I'm running ZVM 720. So let's log on. So we'll be using the PUT2PROD command, and whenever you use that or the service command, the service file pool needs to be up. To check that, we issue query FILEPOOL CONNECT FOR our guest and the name of the service file pool. And we see that it's up and we are connected. If it was down, the first thing you would try is xautologging the guest vm serve p, which is the guest that runs file pool. Now, if you just want to get rid of the shared ystat not available, or shared sstat not available messages, you just need to rebuild the CMS saved segment. And you do that with PUT2PROD save CMS. And that's it. These messages are caused by the 190S disk or 19EZY disk being changed since the CMS NSS was last saved. So moving on. Say you do a CP query NSS to see all of your segments defined on the system, but you notice some are missing and you aren't sure which ones. To demonstrate, I'll do CP purge NSS all, and then query again. And see how it says 5 files are pending purge. And the P here under class. That means at least one guest is still using that save segment, and it won't be deleted until nobody is using it. So if we were to re-IPL or recycle every guest using these segments, they would go away. Now to rebuild everything, you do PUT2PROD segments all. And this will build or rebuild every saved segment defined to VMSys. This could take a while if you have a lot of segments. Now that that's finished, we should have all of our segments back. And you'll still see those pending purge old ones. But they'll go away with a re-IPL or recycling every guest using them. And you can get a list of those guests with CP query NSS users, and then choose a segment like CMS. And you'll see these are all the guests that would need to be recycled for this CMS save segment to go away. And of course, it's always a good idea to do a VMF view after it puts prod or service. And we see we have no errors. So now you can also rebuild individual save segments by specifying the save segment name like CMS-BAM instead of all with PUT2PROD segments like this. And you can specify any segment And that's it. Lastly, the three most important files pertaining to saved segments are the segbuild PPF, the segbuild list exe00000, which is a build list, and the segbuild list segdata file, which contains build info for all the segments defined in the build list. They live on the 5.1 dog, and you don't want to manually edit these files. When you want to make changes to a saved segment, the first place you turn is the tool VMPSFS, where you can make changes such as where in storage a segment resides. And that's it. You can read more in Save Segments Planning and Administration, link below. Thanks for watching.